Welcome to the Grazing Game, a contest where you try to guess which plant-eating animal will finish their meal the fastest. Our first two competitors are both great grazers. They are Billy the Buffalo and ZZ the Zebra. It's time for you to pick which one of these animals you think will finish their food the fastest. All right, grazers, get ready. Get set. Go! It looks like ZZ the Zebra is off to a really fast start. She's doing great. It seems like Billy the Buffalo chews a lot slower, but takes some really big bites. Who is going to finish first? All I know is that it's going to be close. Wow! Billy the Buffalo stages a huge comeback. The winner this time is Billy. Up next is a challenge between two very tall grazers. A little higher, please. Yes, great, thank you. The challengers this time are Jesse Giraffe and Gerard Giraffe. Who do you choose to win? Ready. Set. Go! They're both munching away. Oh no, folks. It appears that a bee is distracting Gerard Giraffe. Okay, the bee is gone and Gerard Giraffe takes a huge bite. And he finishes all of the leaves on the branch. The winner this time is Gerard the Giraffe. This just in, folks. ZZ the Zebra has requested a rematch. For our final contest, the grazers again are Billy Buffalo and ZZ Zebra. Who do you think will finish their meal first? Okay, grazers, ready. Set. Go! They're both munching away. Will Billy the Buffalo come back once again? And ZZ Zebra finishes first. She is the winner. We hope you've had a good time playing the Grazing Game.
Sure is hot out here. No, I don't mind though. Just glad to be free.
Break free, 'cause you see I have been. much pressure fell on me. I thought I was gonna lose my mind. But I know you wanna see if I will hold on through these trials. But I need you to lift this load, cause I can't take it no more.
I took the shackles off my feet so I can dance.
So I can dance.
I just wanna praise.
Woo, woo, woo.
I just wanna praise.
Yeah. Woo,
woo.
We'll be right back. do you like that song? I sure do. And when we get further into this lesson, we're going to learn more about pleading the blood. We have prepared such an awesome lesson, so get ready, get your pens, get your paper, and get seated. This lesson is fantastic. Hello, boys and girls, and welcome back. Today, we have another exciting lesson from There's Power in the Blood. Today, the title of our lesson is Pleading Your Case. But before we get started at our lesson, let's pray. So can we have heads bowed and eyes closed as we start our prayer? Father, we thank you for each and every person that's under the sound of my voice. We thank you that you have prepared their hearts and minds to hear and receive your word. Thank you that your word is planted in the rich soil of their hearts. Thank you for the fruit that will come forth. We desire to honor you at all times. Use me now to teach your word with excellence. We thank you for the harvest in Jesus' name. Amen. Did you notice the teacher in the previous classroom slide had on a black robe? Did that make you think of anything? Anything in particular at all? A black robe? If you said you thought of a judge, then you're right. That's part of this lesson. Let's take a good look at our power verse. Plead my case and redeem me. Give me life according to your promise. Psalms 119, verse 154. The word plead is used when a person or a lawyer goes before a judge. The word case refers to the reason why you are standing before a judge. You might be asking yourself right about now, what does this have to do with the blood of Jesus? Well, let me just say this, everything. If you were around for our earlier lessons, you might remember when we explained to you that the children of Israel were told to put the blood of a lamb, which we know represents the death of Jesus Christ, over their door lintels and their doorpost, and that would protect them from the death angel. Do you remember that? If not, you can go back and listen to some of our older lessons. We want to make sure you have clear understanding that it's Satan's desire to have us, the children of God, condemned. He wants us to be found guilty with no redeemer. Satan did not know that Jesus' death on the cross sealed the deal for us. Glory to God, we win. Because of Jesus' death, Psalms 103, verses 3 through 4, came to life. It says, whom forgives all your, which is our, iniquities, which means sin, who heals all your, which is our, diseases, who redeems you, us, our life, from the pit, who crowns you, which is me and you, with steadfast love and mercy. Look at God. In other words, the blood of Jesus redeems, or should I say, saves our lives from destruction. It will protect us from hurt, harm, or danger as we walk in faith, not fear. God made his children, which are us, a promise in Psalms 34, verse 7. It says, because we know that Father God cannot lie. His word will never change. God is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Psalms 34 verse 7 reads as follows. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him, and he delivers them. What a promise! God's angels are around us, protecting us from seen and unseen dangers all day, every day. They never take a vacation day, and they definitely will not call in sick. They are honoring God's word. Our angels battle the forces of hell on our behalf. As it is written, he will give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. Satan does not want us to know that God has given us the power to overcome him with his word. He doesn't want us to know that. He doesn't want us to know that God's words are weapons to defeat him. He doesn't want us to know that. He doesn't even want us to read the Bible. He doesn't want us to know anything about pleading the blood. When we, meaning you and I, plead the blood of Jesus, neither Satan nor his demons can cross that bloodline. It's a sinless bloodline. He doesn't want us to know that. He doesn't want us to know that there is power in the blood of Jesus. Oh no, he does not want us to know that. When a problem or a situation comes up in our lives that we can't handle, we can plead the blood of Jesus over that problem. When we have faith that God will keep his word, do you remember when the children of Israel put the blood on the post of their doors? Jesus' blood will protect us. Our angels are working for us. They never stop. Psalms 91, verse 10 through 11 says, no disaster can overtake you. No plague can come near your tent. He has given his angels order about you to guard you wherever you go. God has already covered us. His blood has done it all. When we love and follow Father God, we are under his protection. No demon in hell can take us out of the palm of his hand when we love and follow Father God. Now, everything I'm sharing with you is true. However, Satan does not want you to know the truth. He wants you full of doubt and unbelief. Why is that, you ask? Well, let me tell you. Satan knows if he can keep you full of doubt and unbelief, he wins. So, we should say what God said at all times. That's right. Remember, for the blood to work for you, you must have faith and not doubt. You see this lady here? She's scratching her head saying, faith in who? Faith in what? Well, let me tell you. You have heard the word, and all that you have heard is true. If you would like to become part of Jesus' family, raise your hand. Some might want to kneel. It's your choice. There is no age limit with God. He doesn't care how old you are. You can be 3, you can be 99 or 103. He does not care. Faith in what? Faith in who? Faith and the Son of God. If you would like to be part of Jesus' family, please repeat after me. Father God, I come to you now just as I am. I believe Jesus is the Son of God. I believed he died on the cross for me and was raised on the third day. I believe he is seated on the right hand of Father God, making intercession for me. Lord, live your life in me and through me from this day forward. I thank you for causing me to become all that you have called me to be. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Woohoo! Welcome to the family. Welcome to the family. All of heaven is rejoicing. All of heaven is rejoicing. I am so excited. You just made the most important decision of your life. Satan is so mad, he doesn't know what to do. But I do. Praise the Lord. Yes. Guess what, guys? From this day forward, when Satan tries to accuse you, the answer will be not guilty, not guilty, not guilty. Thank you for joining us today. And we'll have another exciting lesson for you next week. And we're looking to see you there. Bye-bye for now.